What's up, my naturals? So today I'm going to be discussing a topic that everybody really don't talk about. Everyone in natural hair community talks about, like, you know, I love being natural. Oh my God, it's the best thing that ever happened to me. And all these positive things, which is great. But I feel like we don't really have a lot of videos that discuss the real when it comes down to natural hair, like the cons and the struggles that we have and upkeep for natural hair. So I'm gonna go into a couple of, like, things that I feel like needs to be discussed and represented, you know what I'm saying? And be upfront and be real about having natural hair, period. It's gonna be a little short video. Just wanna bring you guys some content and just talk to you guys for a second. So basically, I didn't write anything down, but I'm gonna be looking at my phone just to give me some, you know, ideas. But I know in my head what I got. I'm probably gonna be discussing a few of them. So from top of my head, I would say the biggest thing about having natural hair, whenever you cut your hair, you know what I'm saying, if you decide to do a big chop, I kind of transitioned and I had a good amount of, like, a new growth from, so I wasn't really like a really, really short, but it was short to my, like, to my, I didn't like how short it was. My hair never been that short ever in my life. So that was a big thing for me. But the first thing I'm going to be discussing that I don't really like about my, that not like about my natural hair, not natural hair, but my natural hair. So basically the first thing I want to talk about is the tangling up, like, in the knots and everything. So once your hair starts to grow and everything, you're going to start experience a lot of knots and tangles. And that's one thing I really don't like. When I first did my big chop, my hair was all nice. I never really experienced that many tangles. But as your hair starts to grow, you notice you're starting getting a lot of those, like, fairy knots or just tangles. It's kind of annoying, you know? It's kind of annoying. I love my hair texture. I love my hair tight. Sometimes I wish my hair was just, like, curly, not to just, like, run my hair through it, just be curly and curly. But, you know, I love my hair, but that's just one of the cons. Second con is the cotton. Y'all, when I say the cotton is real, like, even if I tie my hair down, I still get cotton in my head. Like, I can be just wash my head and detangling and everything, and I always end up getting cotton in my hair. Like, it's super freaking annoying. And I hate finding cotton in my hair because I now gotta, like, pick through my hair and finding cotton. Like, cotton is not your best friend when you become natural. So just to let y'all know, y'all think about going natural, be ready for that cotton, because that cotton will become your worst enemy, just to be real with y'all. What's another thing I hate about being natural?
Or, period.
Another thing I dislike about or don't really like being natural is that it's really kind of expensive, because natural hair, it's hard to find natural hair care products that actually work for your hair. Because whenever you're starting out, whenever you're transitioning, you're gonna, like, be buying products and trying to figure out what works for you, and that stuff actually adds up. It really does. Like, I was really bad at going out and buying the first thing I seen, or I go on YouTube and be like, oh, this product works for your hair. I'm going to the store, I'm copying that product, and guess what? End up not working for my hair. So that's another, like, thing that I really like when they first go natural, and people don't really tell you, hey, every product does not work for you. Don't go out and buy every product that people recommend, because it's not gonna work for your hair, and you're gonna be left with product just sitting there. Like, right now, I got a drawer full of products that I never used, probably used only one time, and they're still full up to the top. And, like, I'm like, why did I even buy this? Why did I waste my money on this product knowing that it wasn't gonna work for my hair? I didn't know that, but I was just really bad at just going to the store, watching YouTube videos, going to the store and just picking up whatever people are recommending. But you gotta figure out what's the best for your hair. start with something simple and stick with it, or just like experiment, but don't like go heavy. Don't just buy this product, buy that product, buy this product. Buy the product, just that one product or two products, and just figure it out first. I'm just gonna like just grabbing like 10 different products. So I want this leave-in, I want this curl definer, I want this shampoo, I want to try this shampoo too, I want to try this conditioner, because that money gonna add up, baby. Like, now I try to get a product that works for my hair. I just try to stick with it. It's good to go new, but half of the time you want to make sure that you are sticking with a product that works for you, because your hair can become like stressed out if you're steady changing out products, like changing like frequently. So you want to stick with a product that actually works for your hair for a good minute. You know, I figure out that works for my hair. Like, I find a product that works, I just stick to it and just, you know, try new things as we go. But I try my best not to you know, get too many products at one time, knowing that it might not work for my hair, and just save money. Another thing is, I don't say like about natural hair, is that people, y'all, let me tell you, this is the most, y'all, let me tell y'all, this is something that really gets on my nerve when it comes out of having natural hair. It's not on my natural hair, it's not on me, but because people seem to want to touch your hair and ask you to touch your hair, like, you can ask, but then people stare too, like, people that are not like our color or not the same race as me, they tend to stare at your hair. Some, it can be like good staring, like, oh my god, I love your hair. Some stares, you know, is hate. Like, they give you a look like that stare when the different, another stare is like, but that stare when it be like, you know the difference between a stare, like a, oh my god, an admiring her hair, and like a hate, disgusted way. That pissed me off, because I went to the nail shop today, and this lady, she wasn't my race, I'm not gonna say, you know, she wasn't my color, and she was just staring at me. I'm like, what's she staring at me for? It wasn't a good stare, she was looking at me like, is it my hair? Like, what is it? And I feel like a lot of times people do stare when you go out and about, and in the disgusting way, like, I can't wear my natural hair or whatever, and that kind of bothers me a little bit still. Like I said, I love my hair, but I hate when people stare. Like, what's the problem? Because my hair is not straight, and it's not all whatever flowing, flowy. Like, I can straighten my hair, and it can be flowy, baby. But guess what? I'm not going to straighten my hair to be light or to be fit in with society, because that's not who I am. And I love my natural hair, and that's, it is what it is. But like, if they give me like a nasty stare, it's, I just kind of ignore it. Last time I stare back at them and be like, you staring at me, I'm gonna stare at you. Like, what's up? Period. But that's like one of the things I really hate the most, not like towards my hair, but being natural. Like, people stare, and I know that they're staring at my hair probably, but it is what it is. And another thing I don't like is people want to touch my hair, you know, and stuff like that. I don't like that. I had a girl one time that touched my hair, and she was playing, like, I was in like this training or like a school, whatever. I'm not gonna go into detail, but I had this female one time that I had my hair back into, I had my hair slicked back, and my hair was just like blown out and nice and pretty, but I had my hair slicked back into a puff ball, and my puff ball was like huge, you guys. My puff ball was like really big, like huge. And I had this girl, this white girl, whatever, but she came, I'm gonna say race, whatever, she came up to me, and she basically touched my hair, like she like, was like, I forgot exactly what she said, but she was just like boing, boing, or something like that to my hair. Like, I can feel it. I guess she didn't know if I can feel that, but she just like bounced my hair. She said something, I forgot exactly what she said, but I know she touched my hair, and she was like doing like that. So that's when I turned around, and I was like, yeah, when I tell y'all, I was ready to swing on this girl. I was ready to swing, I was ready to fight, but I put her in her place, because I was like, first of all, I'm not a pet. Don't put your hands on me. Don't touch me. Period. Because I was like, who do you think you are? Like, you feel like you have power. You have, you know, a right or a power just to, that you can just do whatever you want to do to people and touch people with it, however you want to do it. I was like, who is she? Like, who are you to come up to somebody and touch their hair and touch me, my property? Like, this is my body, which is my property. Like, you have no right to come up to me and touch my hair. Like, to touch nothing on my body, period. I don't care if it was a plain matter. You don't touch nobody here and go boing with somebody here. Like, I would never forget that. I would never, like, forgive her. Well, that's kind of the sense of, I gotta forgive you because I'm a Christian. But I will never forget what she did. I'll never forget that lady. I'll never forget her. Like, one thing you don't do, don't touch my hair, period. Like, don't touch my hair. That's one thing you do not do. That's what I hate about one thing about it being natural thing. Another thing about being natural that's kind of like weird is that sometimes when you're trying to wear a wig, do y'all know how much strength it takes to wear a wig? Like, it takes so much work. Like, I don't gotta wash my hair, I gotta do this, gotta do that. And like, either you're gonna get your hair braided, you gotta get a corner braided down in order for the wig not to be all bumpy. Or what I do, I found something that works for me. I basically like twist my hair and I have to do this and do that to make my hair look flat underneath the wig and so it can look nice. But y'all, it's a struggle. It's a struggle trying to get your hair up under a wig when you're natural. But I'm gonna do a video on that too. That's a good video. Let me write this down so I forget. But I'm gonna do a video on it. I'm gonna type this in so I can screenshot it. How to wear a wig while natural. How do we wear natural? I don't know. While having natural, with natural hair. I don't know what sounds better. But I'm gonna do a video on that too. That sounds pretty good. Off topic. Anyway, five kinds are tangles and knots. Secondly, cotton. Third is going to be people staring at my hair like they're disgusted. Number four is people wanting to touch my hair or touching my hair without my permission. And number five is the struggle of we're trying to put on a wig, wear a wig while you're natural. You got a lot of hair. It's definitely a process, especially if you want to protect your hair underneath your wig. You want to make sure your hair is properly detangled and everything if you're going to be wearing a wig. And that's, like I said, that's a process in itself. So those are my five cons, you guys, with being natural. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to try to bring some vlogs to y'all. I'm trying to get this editing thing together. I got to get certain things for my camera that I didn't know I actually needed. But I'm going to try to get this together because I want to do some vlogs, you guys. And I want to get something out there and do some like morning routines, workout routines, just something to that nature. What do you guys want to see on my channel more? Like vlog type, like information. Like, y'all comment below and let me know what y'all want to see on my channel. Y'all want to see working out? Y'all want to see morning routines, night routines with my hair? Like, y'all let me know, okay? Shopping, we can do some shopping vlogs. Anything, it doesn't really matter. But y'all let me know about that. Y'all just let me know, okay? But thank y'all for watching this video. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below. And yeah, you guys, thank you for watching. Hey, toodles. Peace.